I know I'm not much of a photographer, but my photos always turn out amazing.
I'm no fitness expert, but I know my body better than anyone.
Fashion isn't everything to me, but I express myself in my own unique way.
Even at the speed of life, I can still live life at my own pace.
No matter where I am, there isn't a moment I won't be ready for. For all the things that make life even better.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Pooja Yadav, and I'm honored to say that I will be your host for today. Now, firstly, a big thank you to each and every one of you, everyone in the front, everyone in the back. Thank you so much for being with us here today. It means a lot to us. Because frankly, it's a big day for us. We are super excited to be bringing to you the outstanding, the amazing Samsung Galaxy S5. We will also be unveiling to you a host of outstanding gear products. So big day, all I can say is sit back, relax and enjoy the show because boy, do we have a show for you. Now, let me begin by saying that I'm sure some of you might have heard about these products. Again, who am I kidding? Really, I'm sure all of you have heard a lot about these products. The internet has been abuzz with activity. It's been exploding with information about what is coming up. And we are here to end that suspense. Because shortly, we shall be unveiling our brightest, newest star from our galaxy. So before that, let me tell you a little about these wonderful devices. They are, of course, like all our products, developed and designed with the best and latest of technology. And all this to enhance our daily experience. Also, ladies and gentlemen, these devices, they showcase our efforts to bring truly meaningful innovation to the mobile marketplace. So simply put, what these devices do is that they put the world in our hands and they free us so that you, I, all of us, we can live our lives to the fullest. So having said that, let's kickstart the show. It is truly my privilege to welcome on stage Mr. Vineet Taneja, Country Head, Mobile and IT, Samsung India. Welcome, sir. Do tell us about the inspiration behind these products.
So warm welcome to all of you. And I think Pooja almost covered 50% of what I wanted to say anyway. But I will indeed go through a few slides to take you through what we're really excited about today, which is the launch of the Galaxy S5 and of course the entire gear series that we are introducing as well today. If you look at this slide, it has a few words that you also saw in the AV. My life, yeah? Mobile technology, as we all know as consumers and as experts in this field or people who are interested in this field, has indeed engulfed our life rather holistically, yeah? The second word that I want to focus on is powered. Yeah? What is happening with mobile technology is that it is indeed helping us to power our lives very differently. It is helping us to live a better life, a more holistic life, a life that is connected, and so on and so forth. And therefore, this slide is extremely important, and you would hear this entire word, my life, all along my presentation and when my colleague Manu comes up and talks about, you know, what is so special about the Galaxy S5. Mobile innovation has indeed grown by leaps and bounds. We in Samsung are proud that we've been able to lead this innovation in this field very successfully. What we've been able to do is that with every successful launch, we have built on what we already had and introduce something new. So if you look at our range, specifically the Galaxy S range, you will see that we started with the Galaxy S, then the S2, the S3, and S4, and today we will talk about the S5. With every successive product and every successive model, we've been able to take technology to the next level. We've been able to bring to life technology in a way that consumers start using it in a very, very different way. And I think that's what we're very, very proud of. In specific, the Galaxy S series has been our flagship series because it has been able to drive the entire adoption of smartphones in this country and across the world. And it has been able to make sure that consumers experience mobile technology in a very, very real way, in a very, very interesting way that helps their life. So that's really the Galaxy S. As you can see, this is the range, starting with the Galaxy S right up to the S4. And thanks to our innovation and our go-to-market strategies in this country, that is the number of people in India that today have a Galaxy smartphone in their pocket. 35 million, or 3.5 crore Indians today proudly possess a Galaxy smartphone. And of course, some tablets as well. But at an overall level, that is the number. And it is a staggering number. It has made us really leaders in this field. And we want to, of course, build on this leadership position that we have with every successive model. And I think central to our success has been our very, very deep connect with our consumers. We talk a lot about technology, but frankly, technology for technology's sake is absolutely not a very good business idea. We who are really passionate about technology can talk about it, and there are some consumers who are very passionate about technology, and we do appeal to them. But I think at a broader level, what consumers want is not technology. They want something which can change their lives, which can help them live a better life, be more productive, entertain them, be connected with their network in India or across the world, and so on and so forth. So they're really looking for something that can help them live a better life. And I think that's the big insight that we've been working on. All our conversations, all our consumer work tells us that that is what you should really focus on rather than scare people with technology only. And that's why we call it meaningful innovation. We want to bring innovation that is meaningful to our consumers. And these are the five pillars. And it's just coincidence that it is S5, and we have talked about five pillars. And you'll see 2 to the power 5 and this number 5 as a very important part of our entire marketing program. Because what we discovered was that there were really 5 big things that consumers were looking for in their devices. The first was design. They didn't just want technology and you know, slick-looking technology just for technology's sake. They said, I want a design that I can be proud to own, something that I can be proud to show in my hand. When I sit on a table, I put out my phone and I be proud about it. So design is an extremely important element of what consumers want in their smartphones. The second thing, cameras have been in smartphones or even feature phones ever since I can remember, right? I think maybe 10, 12 years. But still, the reality is, I mean, I wish I could show you a picture. There was a picture that I saw recently of an event which was held 10 years ago, and there were people just clapping and looking at the show. And an event today where everybody puts up their smartphones and starts taking pictures. Camera has become a ubiquitous thing in our pocket. And as camera becomes important and people start taking more and more pictures, sharing it with their friends, the quality of the camera becomes extremely crucial. People don't want to carry 2 devices. That's a given today. So therefore, we focused on cameras. People want a camera that is really good, has a user interface that can help them take good quality pictures instantly. Third, speed. People want to do different things at the same time. Multitasking is the name of the game as far as smartphones is concerned. People want to be able to do a chat and look at a video at the same time. People want their smartphones to become faster and faster, not just from a processor point of view, but also from a connectivity point of view. So therefore, speed is a third pillar that we feel is critical to deliver something good to the consumers. The fourth thing, and especially I think this is a growing trend even in India today. Staying fit or staying healthy is absolutely paramount. People want to live a fuller life by being fit. And all of us know that most of us carry a device and would like to be connected when you are doing something in the gym or going running outside or so on and so forth. And one of the things that consumers kept telling us is, I wish I had a device that could help me monitor my fitness regime and so on and so forth. So staying fit was the fourth pillar that we really focused on. And of course, the fourth and last one is life in general, because as we go more and more connected with our smartphones, we want to make sure that all our life is connected through my device. So those were the five pillars, so to speak, of that we really focused on when we were looking at designing the next S series. So can we have the video now, please? So ladies and gentlemen, proud to present the Galaxy S5, and that's really the range of colors that we will launch the S5 with. I'm going to just very, very briefly talk about the top few features of the Galaxy S5, and then I'll leave the detail to my colleague Manu to kind of come and go through all that detail. But I did think it would be useful to just give you a top line of what are the big features of Galaxy S5. Like I said, powerful camera. It's the fastest autofocus camera you can ever find in a smartphone. More details on what's the speed and lag, etc., that Manu will share with you. A very, very good high definition resolution, so to speak, of gives you a very big rich tone and a very improved user experience. Speed, of course, this is a 3G smartphone with speeds up to 42 Mbps if the network allows that. And it is a true octa-core processor, so clearly helps you with multitasking and doing various things at the same time. I talked about stay fit and a little bit more as I go along, but clearly it has many things that you can do with this, like heart rate monitor and so on and so forth. Again, more details later. What our consumers were also telling us is, look, when I'm out, I'm always worried that, you know, some water will fall on it, or my smartphone will get damaged because of water and dust and so on and so forth. So it is water and dust resistant. So I think that's a big thing. We don't expect people to swim with their smartphones yet, but yeah, definitely if some water was to fall on it, or you know, you were in a dusty environment, you do want to make sure that your smartphone is intact. And that's what is an important feature that comes in with the Galaxy S5. We are, of course, building this entire platform of Knox that we've spoken about. Security is becoming a big concern amongst consumers. They want two big things to happen. One is that if they lose their phones, they want to be very assured that their data is secure. We also know that all of us who work as employees in a company also want to make sure that your personal data and your professional data remain intact and remain in two separate compartments, so to speak of. So Samsung Knox that we've spoken about, Samsung Galaxy S5 does come powered with Knox, and that's a big thing for most people who work as professionals or have a work and personal life which they do with their same smartphone. And this is a very interesting feature. I think almost all of us want better and better battery life, right? But more importantly, I think what we all want is that when you're in that situation where you're down to 5% battery or 10% battery, and you're in a situation where you don't have a charging point or a power bank, or you're not in your car which has a car charger, and you're in this situation that you still want, that's like a movie hall, yeah? And you don't have a power bank, you still want to be available for the next 3 hours, yeah? I think there is an ultra power saving mode that we're launching with Galaxy S5, which Manu will talk about, which lets you be on standby. So can't do too many things, but at least your phone will remain active for days. It also has got, you know, God forbid something was to happen and you're in a situation where you're not connected with the world, except with your mobile phone, and you have nothing accessible in terms of charging, this could last you a few days and could be quite a lifesaver. So a very, very good feature, and more about it as Manu talks about the details. And I think last but not the least, like I said, comes with absolutely beautiful colors and has a perforated back that looks very, very chic and very, 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 very sleek. So something really nice, something we're very, very excited about. And as we let you after this presentation to have a look and touch about this device, you will realize that these four colors and the look and feel of the product is really awesome. And now I come to the next range, next part of the presentation today, and that's about this very exciting category of wearables. So can we have a video, please? Yeah, so I'm proud to introduce three Gear products, actually. The first one we had launched, as you know, we had launched this entire category along with the Note 3 6 months back, and we've got a reasonable response on it. But we did take consumer feedback, and the feedback that we were getting was there were some people who said, I don't need the camera. Some people were saying, I want something that I can change my strap. Some people said, you know what? If I'm going to use this while I'm doing some exercise, I want it to be light. And that's where GearFit came in. So clearly, we listened to consumers and we said, clearly there are three opportunities that we have, which is why we're launching three Gear products, the Gear 2, the Gear Neo, which doesn't have a camera, and GearFit, which is just a light product that you can, you know, use while running, while generally people who don't like heavy things on their wrist like me, GearFit is just a very, very awesome product. And like I said, we will talk about it in detail. Those are the two products, Gear 2 and Gear Neo. And you can see that we have not compromised on colors. We do realize that in wearables, you know, the look and feel and the fashion quotient of these products needs to be much higher. And that's why you will see that the colors that we're launching would really make it very, very desirable for people who are very, very style conscious. And if you want just a regular product, then you wear something like this, which is black. And GearFit. So GearFit is something that, again, details later, but gives you notifications and so on and so forth. So a lot more about it as we go along. It has a heart rate monitor that you can see at the back. So and it's very, very light, like I said. So just to summarize, I think our innovation and our efforts are such that our innovation remains open. So we are on the Android platform and work with a series of people in the ecosystem and make sure that we are very, very using a very collaborative approach. We also realize that in this category, you have to be extremely nimble-footed and flexible. And that's why whether it is our innovation on the S5 or whether it's an innovation on our Gear products, we've made sure that we are using whatever technology it takes to make sure that consumers get a very good experience. So those are the three pillars on which our innovation is based, because at the end of the day, we do believe that our innovation needs to be inspired by people and also should inspire people, which are our consumers, to lead a better life. And that really is the end of my presentation. Like I said, Galaxy S5 and the Gear range is what we're introducing today. So I'm very, very happy that, and thanks for your patience and attention, and I think we will now look at the range. So can we have the range, please?
Okay. Hi, how are you?
Good to see you. Thank you. Oh, 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 oh
lega questi luoghi e anche questi fiori azzurri. Via, via, neanche questo tempo grigio, pieno di musica e di uomini che ti son piaciuti. It's wonderful, it's wonderful, it's wonderful, good luck my baby, it's wonderful, it's wonderful, it's wonderful, and remove you, chips, chips, da-ti-do-di-doo, chi-boom, chi-boom-boom, da-ti-do-di-doo, chi-boom, chi-boom-boom, da-ti-do-di-doo. Via, via, vieni via con me, entra in questo amore buio, non perderti per niente al mondo. Via, via, non perderti per niente al mondo, lo spettacolo d'arte varia, io un innamorato di te. Yeah. It's wonderful, it's wonderful, good luck my baby, it's wonderful, it's wonderful, it's wonderful, I dream of you, chips, 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 da-ti-do-di-do, chi-boom, chi-boom-boom, da-ti-do-di-do, chi-boom, chi-boom-boom, da-ti-do-di-do. Questo amore buio, pieno di uomini. Via, via, entra e fatti un bagno caldo. C'è un accappatoio azzurro, fuori piove un mondo freddo. It's wonderful, it's wonderful, it's wonderful. Good luck, my baby, it's wonderful. It's wonderful, it's wonderful. I dream of you, chips, chips. Da-ti-do-di-do, chi-boom, chi-boom-boom. Da-ti-do-di-do, chi-boom, chi-boom-boom. Da-ti-do-di-do.
Mr. Vineet Taneja, Ms. Frida Pinto, and Mr. Manu Sharma presenting the Samsung Galaxy S5 and the next generation of Samsung Gear Wearables.
We'll be right back.
Okay, big moments happening right here.
Yeah, you want some more?
I know you can't get enough of this particular shot, but believe me, we have ample time and opportunities for more photo moments. Request to all our members from the media to please settle down. We have lots more time. Thank you so much, Vineet. Thank you, Frida.
Thank you.
And Manu, you have... Don't worry, we'll get back. We'll get her back on popular demand, so don't worry. So there's going to be lots of time. Thank you so much, Vineet.
Can I have the...
Manu, please do us the honor of giving us an in-depth look into this amazing lineup.
Very good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, members of the media. It's once again an honor to be in front of you to talk more about the next Galaxy device. It's just a privilege. Let's go deeper dive into what really the product has to offer and what Galaxy S5 is really all about. As Vineet talked about, it's Samsung's mission to bring technologies and devices which improves human lives. It's at the heart of Samsung that whatever we do in terms of building devices, we follow that path. And when we were building the Galaxy S5, and we were building the idea of the Galaxy S5, we went back to the customers to really understand what are the key essentials that you're looking for in the devices, which will help improve their lives, and which is fundamental, which is meaningful and relevant in their lives. We really found five key aspects in that. First, customers, because of their modern lifestyle, are looking for a device which represents their own personality. They're looking for a design with modern look and glam look. They're looking for a camera which is great and very simple to use. They're looking for a device which will give them unmatched speed with the demands in their life. They want a device which is protected based on their lifestyle. And of course, they want a device which can help them stay fit. And if a smartphone is able to do that, that's even better. So let's look at how each of these elements live in the Galaxy S5 and how Samsung went back to the basics to really figure out how meaningful innovations through these insights we can bring in the Galaxy S5. Design. Clearly, our customers are looking at really modern design, which is urban, versatile, and dynamic. They're not just looking at design which is smart. They're looking at design which is insightful. They're looking at design which is really stylish. If you look at the Galaxy S5, it's got this perforated back, which is very comfortable to hold and gives a natural grip. The shimmer you see at the back of the Galaxy S5 is at its heart of its glam look as a result of this perforated, unique design. This is electric blue that you see on the screen. It's my favorite. It's just fantastic looking design. And the Galaxy S4 will come in four brilliant colors. Electric blue, shimmery white, charcoal black, and copper gold. Each one which will represent a unique taste of individuals' preferences. Now, moving on to the user interface. We have really refined the user interface and made it much more vibrant, with geometric patterns which actually inspired by the effects of prisms from the diamond. And we made the UI very clean and simple. It is very uncluttered. When you actually navigate through the settings tool, you will realize the icons are much larger with much more visual display. And it's, of course, very easy to navigate. Talking about the screen. Galaxy S5 display is 5.1-inch full HD Super AMOLED display and you can't get any better than that. So whether you're watching that video or playing games, you're gonna get the best experience when it comes to your display. Now, our displays are not just brilliant, they're very intuitive. The Galaxy S5 has something called local contrast enhancement. What it really does is it, through the algorithm, it analyzes and segments the incoming light on the device, and basis that, it actually changes the effect on the screen. So for example, if you are in a blazing sun outdoors, you don't have to squint your eyes to read on the display. At the same time, it works the other way. It becomes super dim. So depending on the environment that you are, and the classic example, if you are in a theater watching a movie, the last thing you want your, you know, people sitting next to you getting bothered with the bright light shining. So it becomes super dim. The S5 has adaptive display, which is an enhanced display technology. What it really does is just not take the incoming light. Also, it sees the content that you are looking at, whether it's video, whether it's textbook, and actually optimize the screen to give the best viewing experience. So, for example, if you're reading an e-book, when you're reading an e-book, it automatically optimizes to make it look like that you're reading on a paper. And if you're watching video, it will, of course, work in a dynamic mode. It will give you best color reproduction and color saturation. We have made significant improvements in our battery management and, of course, power management. The Galaxy S5 comes with 2800 milliampere battery, which gives you, 10 hours of web browsing and 12 hours of video playing capability. Also, you can talk on 3G for 21 hours straight, and that's a really, really powerful battery. So, the Galaxy S5 with a great design, a fantastic display, a whole new UI, which is very simple to use, a great control over the UI, plus the best battery management. That's the design part of Galaxy S5. Let's move on to the camera. Camera is one of the most critical elements of our users and what they want from that. That's really the core. And as we all know, and Vinny just mentioned, I've seen that picture, we use camera much more than anything else in our smartphones. And even if you have DSLR at home, you will pick up and use your smartphone much more often when it comes to camera. So the Galaxy S5 has something called fast autofocus, which is a new technology that we built in. We have got high dynamic range, which we call rich tones. And of course, we have added whole lots of features, including selective focus that I'm going to talk about. Traditionally, in a smartphone, you have something called contrast autofocus. What we also added is a face detection autofocus, which is found in the professional DSLR cameras, so which give you sharper and very versatile and brilliant images. I must also say, our camera is the fastest in the world. I can literally say that. So no matter what subject you're trying to catch, you can get the picture in just 0.3 of a second. And that's really fast. Coming to the rich tone. The rich tone, really what it does is it controls the light exposure as you focus on a subject. And it gives you the real-life contrast. So what you see is what you get. And typically when you take pictures at times, you'll get this suddenly a dark, gloomy picture which you see on the right because of the light exposure. And it controls that. And this is the first in a smartphone. And it works both in video as well as pictures. Selective focus. So if you want to get a little more edgy about your photography, and I use it quite often on my DSLR, you can use a feature called selective focus. It uses the shallow field of depth that you find in DSLRs, and which allows you to focus on what you want to focus on, and you blur the background. So it gives you a very brilliant picture at times, And this is a great feature. So, the Galaxy S5 camera is something our customers will love. It will give you a much richer, sharper, and vibrant images, which will help our customer capture meaningful moments in an instant. Now, talking about being instant, your camera should be fast enough, of course, to capture that. But in this world, everything is about speed. Speed is the essence. Our lifestyle demands that. And as the mobile technology advances, this becomes a much, much bigger requirement and essential. Of course, we give the best 3G capabilities in terms of speeds at 42 Mbps per second. We have the latest fifth generation Wi-Fi built in our devices, and it comes with octa-core processor, which is a 1.9 quad-core and 1.3 quad-core, which works seamlessly to give a brilliant multitasking experience. Now, while you're catching up your life at speed, of course, you want your device to be protected. You want your content to be protected. And how does that happen? How does the Galaxy S5 helps you do that? Firstly, it protects you from the weather. It's got IP67, so clearly it's water and dust resistant. And of course, it's not waterproof, clearly, as we need to talk about. Don't swim with it. But if it gets wet or if it gets dropped accidentally, you don't have to worry about it. We did also talk about the ultra power saving mode, and that's quite interesting. Now, ultra power saving mode, what it does with just one click, everything on your device, gets shut down except for your calls and your SMS, which are very, very essential and basic for your telecommunication. And it makes the screen a complete monochrome. So you have black and white screen, and you have essentials with you. So for example, on the Galaxy S5, if you're down with just 10% battery, you can actually get almost 24 hours of standby from then on. But that's the beauty of the ultra power saving mode. So while your battery is protected, depends on the circumstances that you are in, data protection is very, very critical as well. Firstly, we also have introduced a finger scanner, which takes your fingerprint as your password, as an identity proof. And this password is actually saved on the device in encrypted form and is never shared, so you're always safe. We have built in something called a private mode. It's a space for you on the Galaxy S5 where you can have your personal files, videos that you don't want to give access to at all. And that can be only accessed through your fingerprint password. We all come back home and we experience our kids snatch our phones, smartphone, and they want to play with it. We have built in something called a kids mode, which is very unique where you don't have to worry about them moving icons away from on the device or deleting some file by mistake. So all you have to do is press the kids mode. It becomes child friendly. They can access various games which are specifically given for and built for them. Plus, you can also give them access to very specific videos or games basis parent and control. So all in all, I talk about the design, I talk about a great camera, I talked about how S5 is really fast, and I'll talk about how it's protected and protects your device. So that's how Galaxy S5 really powers your life. Now moving on to the next topic is the fitness part. Now, fitness is a very, very interesting area, and customers are looking at devices that will help them stay fit, clearly. And imagine if your device is able to, not just track your health and fitness data, and with just an instant. It's just with you all the time. And that's why we have the Gear series, and Gear 2 is an example of that. What we have done is we have really evolved the Gear 1 into the Gear 2 with a lot of changes. We kept the best of Gear 1 and eliminated the pain points which were there on the Gear 1 and built in a lot of new features to make it much more interesting. As a result, it just redefines the way the smartwatches are. So let me talk about the five key elements of our wearable, the Gear. First, wear the smart style. What we have done is the customers are looking at not just a device which is chic and simple to use. So as a result of that, the Gear 2 is now much more functional and, of course, very beautiful. With Gear 2, what we have done is we moved the microphone, the speaker, and the camera onto the bezel. So earlier, that was on the strap, so which really means that you can change your straps and which suits your lifestyle. You can change with different colors, which is orange, brown, and gray. And of course, we also built in the home button based on customer's feedback. So now you have a home button right here, which, so if I'm moving around on the Gear, all I have to do is press the home button, it takes me back in the main screen. So again, useful advantages. We have changed the complete UX. It's refined UX, which allows a greater choice of freedom in terms of choosing themes and application settings. So you could have the face option with an image, picture that you like. You could have a different background, or you can even change font. And of course, it's got a whole bunch of notifications from calls to SMS to alerts, and of course, through various SNS feeds. And it's got 4 GB of internal memory, so it works just like a music player that you have. So all you have to do is transfer all your playlists on this device, and there you have your complete jukebox with you. Now, moving on to the extended ecosystem. This is Samsung's mission, really, to build devices which are interconnected with other devices in part of the bigger ecosystem, and which really help consumer experience and relish the technology. And that's why the Gear 2 has built-in infrared LED, which really lets you control and connect your television to watch on remote. And it's got a plethora of hundreds of applications from lifestyles to health and fitness to entertainment and, of course, commercial. We also released the SDK for this so that the Gear 2 can be enjoyed much more through various platforms. And so developers can actually work seamlessly in terms of building a whole bunch of applications for the Gear 2. Third is more choices. Okay, so we talked about Gear 2. We are also launching a product, Gear 2 Neo. So Gear 2 Neo is a lighter version of Gear 2. So Gear 2 has a camera. Gear 2 Neo doesn't have a camera. It's much lighter, and it's lighter on your wallet as well. So it's much cheaper compared to the Gear 2. So while Gear 1 was perfect companion with Note 3, the Gear 2 is compatible with 17 Galaxy devices, so you can literally work with most of the Galaxy devices. And of course, it's got an enhanced battery. So Gear 1 could last you about a day. This time, we made the power management such that it can last up to 3 days. So it's 3x of battery on Gear 2 that one can enjoy and need not worry about charging it every day. And of course, it also IP67, so it makes it dust and water resistant. So we have gear 2 and gear 2 new. But we have also one more lighter option, which is your gear fit. Now, gear fit is a product which really redefines the category. Vinny talked about it. He loves the product, and it is something which is fantastic. And I feel it's not just for somebody who's into fitness, but also just it looks pretty cool. It looks fantastic. It's the world's first curved Super AMOLED touchscreen on a wearable device. That's first for any device. And it just redefines the category with its beauty and, of course, the technology inside it. With lightweight flexibility, it weighs just 27 grams. And, of course, you can, like the Gear 2, you can change your strap very easily, and it comes in gray, orange, and brown option. It, unlike the various health bands which are out there, you know, which just transmit data, it gives you notifications. So you not only have a great fitness band with you, it also provides up-to-date information in an instant. So all your notification, which works clearly with your Galaxy devices, can be controlled, like you can reject calls, you can set alarms, or you can do a quick reply with basic predefined messages. And the beauty about the Gear Fit is that it's compatible with 20 Galaxy devices. Both Gear 2 and Gear Fit have got built-in heart rate sensor. So what it really does is it really knows how your body is reacting to a workout. So in this example, you know, it also got a pedometer, so you really know how much you walked today, how many steps you've taken, you put a target, and of course, you can have a weekly target and whatnot. So with the heart rate monitor, with the heart rate sensor, it tells you, and you can set your own personal goals, whether, you know, you want to achieve a certain heart rate. And the fitness manager will tell you whether you are slacking off or actually need to speed up, so which is right like a personal fitness coach manager. All these devices work seamlessly with the Galaxy S5 and the all-new S-Health, which is our one-stop solution for fitness, works seamlessly in terms of capturing data of your fitness and health. And you can actually manually add some of your data, such as nutrients, you can and weight and exercise to get much more accurate information about your progress. You can download an application called Coach as part of the S Health, which gives you tips and recommendations of around 5 areas, around exercise, food, sleep, weight, and stress. And of course, on the Galaxy S5, we've also built in the heart rate sensor. So a lot of people might mistake this as an LED flash. This is actually a world's first heart rate sensor on any smartphone. And this is a central part of our S-Health application. So Gear Fit and Gear 2 really allows a lot of freedom for our consumers in terms of they living their life their own way. And to talk about more about the experience of Gear Fit, I'd like to call back on stage Frida to share her views, how her experience has been with the Gear Fit. So can I have Frida on the stage, please? Hi, Frida.
Hi.
You know,
it's all very exciting.
Yes. You know, I know you are a fitness freak and you have very busy lifestyle and, you know, with shooting and whatnot. Mm-hmm. What's your experience have been so far with the Gear Fit?
Yes. Well, so far, I think, and I think from now on, instead of saying so far, from now on as well, I feel the three main things that the Gear Fit has done just helped me in three different aspects of my life. The first being, of course, fitness. And like you said, I am not just a fitness enthusiast because I, you know, want to show off my washboard abs, but I just feel it's very good for my well-being. Right. And sometimes you're just not motivated, and sometimes you need that extra push. So this Gear Fit, I call him.
Yeah.
My personal coach, you know, okay. So I travel with him everywhere I go, and it's you can set your goals, you can continue being motivated, right. And that's great. It's you can when you don't have access to a gym, it's just one of the most wonderful gadgets you can have.
Right.
The second thing, of course, is for me very important. Like you said, I travel so much, so I need to stay connected. Stay right. connected with my people, just know what's happening on the work front. So for messages and calls, this is fantastic, especially when I'm running in Hyde Park.
Right.
And the third thing, which is also very important for me, like most of you already know, is it's a great fashion accessory. If you want to go for a really sleek and classic look, then the black strap's amazing. Yeah. Or like you said, you have the orange strap and you want to add a little bit of color.
Right. So, you know, do you find it very lightweight because it's... Mm-hmm.
It's extremely lightweight, and I have to add that it's very comfortable.
Right.
And it does not hurt my wrists.
Okay.
Because that's one of the things that I feel sometimes certain other gadgets may not bear in mind, that, you know, I've got thin, bony wrists. So the fact that this really takes care of it, and I don't feel that there's something heavy on my wrist, it's great. And of course, the touchscreen is absolutely amazing.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, great. If you'd like, thanks for sharing your feedback. Really
thank
appreciate
you.
It.
Thank you very much.
I hope you really enjoy it.
Oh, yes, absolutely. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Why don't we let him finish his presentation and then I'll come? I feel so disrespectful right now.
Okay, what should I do?
Should I let you finish the presentation?
Yeah, let me finish
the presentation.
And
I promise you I will
come back.
And this is something that I'm very excited about, the gadget and the phone, so I promise you I will come back. Okay? Thank you.
I just got a few more minutes left. I understand. Okay, moving on very quickly. The Galaxy S5 is going to be supported by a whole bunch of accessories from SV cover and flip wallets, and of course, wireless chargeable options. Now, also, of course, we are going to introduce. For music lovers, a bunch of headphones, which are pretty cool and experienced at MWC. We'll be launching very soon these devices, which complements our Galaxy series. The Galaxy gift rewards are really the rewards from our partners. You can get, for example, free subscription to the Wall Street Journal and whatnot. So it really helps you be more productive, and you can enjoy much more on your Galaxy S5. So really, to sum up, there are five key elements the customer is looking for and which really helps them live their lives to the fullest. One is, of course, a design with modern glam look, a great camera which is simple to use and helps them get amazing pictures, the fastest network capability for seamless experience in terms of speeds, a device which is protected based on their own lifestyle, whether they are outdoors, and a device which helps them stay fit through proactive health management. We believe clearly all these five elements live in all three devices that we are launching today, the S5, the Gear 2, and the Gear Fit. So we will go on sale on these devices on 11th of April in the market. We will announce the pre-booking opening on 29th of March. So pre-booking opens for these devices on 29th of March. I'm sure you're waiting for something, which is your price information. So Galaxy S5 is going to be priced in the range of $51,000 to $53,000. We will give you the final price before the launch. The Gear 2 is going to be priced as ₹21,900. The Gear New, as well as Gear Fit, are both going to be priced at ₹15,900. So ladies and gentlemen, these devices are Samsung's commitment to create experiences for our customers, to help them live rich life and to live a life worth the way they want to live. It is our curiosity and it is our innovation which will only grow if we push our boundaries to really deep down understand consumers' needs and we fulfill their needs. And with that commitment and with that promise, I come to the end of my presentation. Thank you very much.
It's now time for our interactive session. We know you have your set of questions, and we're of course here to answer and clarify any queries that you may have. So let me tell you that we shall be passing around cordless mics. Just raise your hand, we will come to you. And I would of course request you to please stand up, introduce yourself and put forth your question.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
It's okay. Thank you.
So just raise your hand, a mic will reach you. Girls?
Perfect.
Okay, so there is a gentleman at the back. Could we have a mic to him?
You know, over time I've done many launches, but the average age of people asking questions is only going down, and I'm really happy about that. India is a young country.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Samyak. I'm from Droid now. Will the phone be 4G enabled?
So the version that we're launching initially is a 3G version. We of course have the option of launching the 4G device. We're just waiting for, you know, some network on 4G to develop, and then of course it'll be easy to just, you know, introduce the 4G version.
Thank you.
I think, gentlemen, you've left them speechless, like really.
I think they found most of the things on the internet. The price was the one big await.
Yeah. Okay, there's a gentleman right in the front. Could we have a mic?
So the average age continues to be low. That's good.
Hi, I'm Rohit from Intellect Digest. My question is about the processor that Intellect Digest. My question is around the processor that is powering this device. The global unveil, we saw that it was powered by an 801 Snapdragon. And this time we get a different processor for India, just like the S4. So why a different processor? And you mentioned in your presentation, it's a true octa-core, but from the specs, it looks like two quad-cores. Are they running
no,
in parallel?
It's two quad-cores. It's an octa-core, but two quad-cores.
So only one will be active at one time, just like the S4?
So both will be activated at the same time.
At the same time.
That's right. So in India, it's related to the first question, which was asked. The Snapdragon is an LTE product. In India, we're launching the 3G, which is an octa-core processor. So we have two quad-cores in them. So this is what we're going to be available in India.
As a customer, if I go and buy a phone off the shelf as it is launched, and say 6 months down the line, if the 4G network is available, then don't I feel like, you know,
6 months down the line, if 4G networks are available, we'll make sure that even before they're available, you know, the LTE version is available.
Doesn't that discourage the customers to buy a 3G version right now?
Well, our experience is that it's people do not want to, you know, buy something that they're not going to be using. So I think that's our understanding from our previous launches.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Next question. Yes, a gentleman in the third row.
Hi, Vineet. My name is Ziya Askari. I work with Telecom Drive. I have a question on the pricing. Keeping in mind today's scenario, the economic scenario that we are going through, don't you think the pricing of this product is a little high? All the products? And keeping the pricing in mind, what kind of expectation would you be having from the market?
So I think the 50,000 barrier on smartphones got broken when we launched the Note 3. Subsequently, other people have launched smartphones at which are, you know, as flagship as our products, beyond 50,000, and the response of these products in the market has been very good. So we find no reason why. At the end of the day, when you give a quality product, there is a certain cost that we incur, and therefore there will be a certain price that that product will be sold at. We also have to keep in mind, you know, the current dollar rate, compared to what it was, let's say, a year back. I mean, at the end of the day, this isn't. There are a lot of components that are imported. Initially, everything will be imported. And therefore, you need to keep that in mind when we do our pricing. Having said that, I think what is important that we've realized is, firstly, people are looking for value. Yeah, I think the cost between a 45 and a 51, 52 is not very different. Yeah, I mean, you're talking to the same target group for whom 5,000-6,000 is not important. What is important is whether he or she is getting good value or not. That's number one. Number two, as you will see when we actually launch the product, we are continuing to drive this entire area of affordability, whether it is through EMIs, whether it is through buybacks of your old phones and so on and so forth, making sure that you can actually not spend 53,000 rupees. You just have to spend a few thousand rupees per month to acquire a Samsung Galaxy S5. And I think that's the trend. We've seen a lot of people upgrading to these devices, largely because of our financing options that we have been really pioneers in terms of pushing in this market. So while the price is, yes, what it is, which itself is not, I don't think, very high, but the financing options make it really affordable.
Okay, thanks.
Hi, this is Sandeep over here from the Mobile Indian.
Yes.
The perforated design looks good. It looks different, but overall,
it looks awesome.
It looks good. The reason being, most of the people
will
be
awesome,
using.
It looks awesome, actually.
Okay.
Even Frida told you that.
We can talk about it later. But the thing is, when the people will put the flip cover over it, so this design will go, because most of the people have a tendency to put a cover or something to protect the devices.
So yeah, cover is an accessory, you know, and
right.
You give an option and some people, you know.
That's right, but overall the design philosophy remains the same as the old Galaxy products. So can we safely say that it will be the last product with the same design philosophy?
You have asked me this question many times and I'll give you the same answer. You know, when you start a design language, you evolve it, okay?
2 years.
No, 3 years actually.
Yeah.
3 years. So when you start a design language, you don't disrupt it for disruption's sake. Consumers have loved this design language. Consumers love to own it. It's not just design, it's also how it's designed in terms of, you know, how you hold it. You know, how the bezels have become smaller and the same screen or larger and larger screen sizes are packed into similar size of the overall device. So the design language cannot be disrupted because consumers love it. If you look across categories, you don't change design language unless you're launching a new series altogether. So I will continue to say that materials have evolved, you know, the entire thinness, the weight has evolved, but the design language just remains the same because consumers love it. There's no reason to change something that's not broken.
And about the gear, like, it is based on Android or Tizen or a mixture of both?
Tizen.
Thank you.
Okay, the gentleman, yes.
Yes, my basic question is regarding is regarding the Tizen software. Is it true that you are moving away from Android, ecosystem, towards Tizen only, so that you will be able to able to have good foothold over operating system and towards the software
so
on the software side?
If you go back to my three mantras of innovation: open, flexible, and collaborative. Right, that's collective. Yeah? Those are the words. Those are the philosophies behind our innovation. And we do want to be flexible because when we decided to go to Tizen instead of Android on our wearable devices, the whole thing was that we felt that it was the right software for this product. It is also a software that will start getting used on other devices, whether it be car control systems, it'll be refrigerators and so on and so forth. And we felt that because it's based on HTML5, it also allows easy app development. So we just felt that it was the right OS for this category of products. That is not to say that we are kind of at all moving away from Android. I mean, you know the Android version of wearables got announced recently. And of course, we will remain open and flexible. For us, what is important is that we offer a good customer experience. OS is actually invisible to the consumers. You know, most consumers don't know which OS, you know, whether this runs on or the device runs on. What they are interested in is a good customer experience.
So your other range will be only on Android only? So
S5 is on Android.
Android.
Yeah, hi.
Gentleman to my front left, yes, absolutely.
Yeah, over there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hi, this is Abhishek from gadgetsteve.com. And my question is regarding the waterproof feature of the phone. So as this device is IP67 certified, and if I have seen that correctly, you have actually covered the USB port of the device as well, so that it can be protected from splash of water. So just in case the water gets inside the device through the headphone jack, which is not actually covered, so will this type, is there any protection on that part as well, which actually will protect the device from the splash of water?
So we will have to come back to you on the questions, but the device has clearly been made. If you look at, of course, the main charger jack, but if you open the back cover also, there's a seal which is there, and you can see when at the demo area, you realize that it protects completely any water to come in from that.
I know, even after you remove the back cover, even then it is protected. Yeah. But the water can go inside the devices from the headphone jack as well, right?
No, it won't, but it will give you detail of that separately.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. Thank you so much. And gentlemen in the second row, yes, sir, your question.
So like I said, on this water resistant, we don't expect people to swim with it. But you know, if you're caught in rain and you're walking, making a call, calling your driver, let us say, while you're in the rain, you're okay. Yeah, so as far as water concerned to the headphone jack, you know, that's not an issue.
Hi, Vinny. Quickly want to check on what retail bundle packages are you going to give with the gear fit and the device? Is there a separate price for a bundle package of gear and the S5?
Currently there is none, but we will look at that maybe in a few months once.
Nothing to launch with.
So just to clarify, and I think for the benefit of everybody, the gear fit actually works, or the entire gear range works with a range of our devices. It is not just, so we are expecting existing consumers, you know, so many of the 35 million Galaxy users, many of them to actually just go and buy a gear fit because it works with their existing device.
Will you be launching the 32 GB version also in India?
And just to clarify, you know, the moment you bundle, you get into all sorts of logistical issues. I bundle a black one, the guy wants a brown one, and stuff like that. Managing the complexity is just not worth it. But what we will do is we will do some smart offers, maybe subsequently, which encourages people who bought our devices in the past few months to actually go and pick up a gear fit and give them some offer, etc.
Sandeep, you're launching 16 GB in India.
Will 32 GB come to India? Will
no, 16 GB is what we're going to be launching.
Thank you.
Will there be any more questions?
Yeah.
Yes.
Hello, sir. I'm from Tech Magnifier. My name is Rahul. So,
down the average age as always.
Yeah. So, is it true that Samsung was planning to make this into a metal phone? Was it? Because we had speculations. We had speculations last year that Samsung will be.
You know, I would say purely speculation.
Okay. Yeah. And second question is, we are not receiving Android updates on our previous Samsung phones. So will you be sending out updates? Because it's problem only in India that we don't receive Android updates on our Samsung phones.
We can apprise you of, we have been giving updates in India clearly. But if you have a very specific example of anything, we can give you of dates when it was released and also for future products, for future releases.
Are you indicating that the updates in India come later than you expect or later than...
Much later, yes.
Not much later. The difference is only of a...
Few weeks, the only
reason why you stagger it, because the moment you get upgrades, everybody goes to the server and starts pinging in down. So we just stagger it for that reason. There is no differential treatment we are providing to Indian consumers by any means.
And does this have a heart rate monitor as well, the phone?
All devices that we've launched today have heart rate sensor in them.
Okay. Thank you.
So we'll take a last question if there is. Yes, okay.
मेरा नाम आशीष पांडे मैं नवभारत टाइम्स से हूं सर गियर फिट या गियर 2 नियो क्या ये अदर एंड्रॉइड डिवाइसेस से नहीं चलेगी या सिर्फ गैलेक्सी के साथ से आप इनको कन्फाइंड
रखेंगे ये सिर्फ गैलेक्सी के डिवाइस के साथ
तो इसके पीछे कुछ खास स्ट्रेटजी है क्योंकि
अगर स्ट्रेटजी है कि मतलब हमारा गैलेक्सी और बिके और गियर फिट ज्यादा बिके यही स्ट्रेटजी
Well, we hope that answers your question. So with that, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to invite Frida back on stage. By popular demand, do us the honor. Gentlemen, we require your services for a photo opportunity. And I request the hotel staff to please remove the basket. Ladies and gentlemen, these devices are Samsung's commitment and vision to create experiences that matter the most to all of us. And we will, of course, always be curious, always be full of innovation as we push the boundaries to satisfy the needs and wants of our customers around the world. I'd also like to tell you that this day will not be complete if you do not visit our demo zone and get a first-hand experience of these fabulous new devices from the house of Samsung. So we invite all of you to please come to our demo zone. And after that, do us the honor of joining us for lunch. It's been fabulous having all of you. Ladies and gentlemen, we will see you at lunch, served in the pre-function area. Thank you so much and have a great day.